We are here at the Royal Society of Medicine in London. Quality is at the top of the healthcare agenda. More than ever before, it is important for us to be clear as to what should we measure and how should we measure it in order to improve healthcare and be safe.
Quality and the integration of care are both essential if we believe, as we surely do, in a patient-centered service. Patients care about the quality of the treatment that they get and the outcome that the treatment achieves. That is why it matters. But also, integration matters for another reason if we believe in value for money for the NHS. And in the end, in a cash-limited system, value for money is essential if we are to treat all the patients that we need to. If we look ahead to the shape of the NHS going forward, I think it will be characterised by two or three main features. More care delivered in the community, fewer centres of acute care, particularly specialist care, and a focus on integration and prevention to enable people only to go to hospital when they need to go and to keep them as healthy as they possibly can be living at home. So this depends on the system being joined up, particularly the way in which primary and community care interact with adult social care. That is, I think, going to be the way of things in years to come.
NICE's main focus is on quality, on ensuring that patients and the public get the quality they deserve. And how else do you know if you're delivering quality if you can't measure it? So we're absolutely committed to helping the system with high quality metrics to allow us to look at this.
So I think the opportunity today is that we've got people coming from hospitals, from primary care, from commissioners to providers, and together we can look at the matrix, the measures that will help influence the way that care improves. Across the NHS, across health care, we need to be much better at measuring patients' outcomes, making sure that people get the service they desire. And we need to measure that well, and today is a real opportunity to drive that agenda forward.
From a nursing community's perspective, I think we need a greater awareness, a greater transparency about staff-patient ratios. We know that that can affect the quality of care. I think we also need to see a greater sharing of those interventions that we know can improve the quality of care and prevent avoidable harm.
I think if they're based on important, accurate, measurable data, which is, if you like, bomb-proof and actionable, which is centred on the patient, then I think those are the robust elements of the data metrics that we have.
I thought today's event was a very useful, and it was a distinguished collection of people talking about the issue that actually is of most concern to patients and taxpayers. That is to say that the care delivered by the health and care system needs to match the aspirations we all have for it to deliver both high quality and good value care. There's not a choice to be made between quality and value. What we need to do is to rethink the way services are delivered so that they're more attuned to the needs of individual patients and use the resources available to the health and care system more effectively than traditional care systems have. I think we should spend less time talking about management structures and more time talking about what goes on in the individual consulting room or in the individual patient's home to enable each individual who uses the system to enjoy a longer life, to enjoy better health, to avoid unnecessary episodes of acute care, because none of us chooses to be in hospital. So if we design a system that's more about identifying risk, intervening early and preventing illness, we would have created a genuine national health service rather than, as so often is the case with our existing structures, a service that provides late care. It is in truth a national illness service rather than the national health service most of us would aspire to deliver.
it was interesting to hear views from procurement, from quality, from the NICE, and a variety of colleagues. And it's a very unusual event to bring so many people together. So I think it's going to be important to distill some messages from all this to see how we can cooperate and take it forward. Need for clarification of what we mean by outcomes. There's a return to, I think, to professionalism, a need for consultant-led quality issues in the hospital and in general practice, procurement issues and purchasing issues, which perhaps don't affect us directly, but which we affect. And so I think consultants will have to be made more aware of the expense that they bring upon the health service. The most expensive item in the health service is this, it's the consultant's pen, because he writes operation, blood test, MRI scan, and I think that's very important that we work together to see if we can contain costs.
I think we heard from the procurement people who we often don't hear from, and I think that's a very important part of how we might get some savings out of the system, which will protect frontline services. I think also an emphasis on clinical leadership and professionalism. I'm from the Royal College of Physicians, and so obviously that's my position, that I think that clinical leadership and the professionals leading issues of quality of care is really important, and I think that claim came out loud and clear. I think also we heard about hearing the voice of patients and how we need to be more responsive to both patient experience and shared decision making with patients. And I think they're both concepts that we need to really put into practice in today's modern health service.
The strategy, better procurement, better value, better care, ultimately it's there to help the NHS deliver 2 billion in procurement efficiency savings by the end of 2015-16. But it's very easy to say that. What needs to happen to make that happen? Well, it's two things really. One, it's a set of top-down initiatives to help trust deliver those savings, such as managing key suppliers, such as working with NHS supply chain, such as working with the government procurement service. But also it's about fixing the longer term issues about improving procurement. Those are the issues around better leadership. So we want trust chief execs to be more engaged in procurement. Very rarely does procurement get talked about at a trust board level, probably once a year if you're lucky. It's about better capability, so we want to improve the trust procurement function. So we're talking about building an academy to help improve the capability. And it's also about data and information. Even in this day and age, we still don't really know what the NHS spends its money on and where it spends its money and who it spends it with. So we want to improve that and improve the data situation.
We've got lots of data that will help us know that care is safe. We can look at outcomes like mortality rates, we can look at complication rates or what patients and the staff think about the safety of the organisation they work in. But for me, one of the most important things is that the people delivering that service take responsibility for it, that they make sure they have the data that they trust that demonstrates that safety, and that they make it public and they share it with patients in a way that is makes them truly accountable.
I think it's been one of the best days for a long, long, long time, because what it's really done is bring together a lot of people interested in the NHS and wanting to do it better. And over the day we've had talks on the metrics and the quality of care, how we collect data, what we can do with it, also where are we going wrong, how do we get the wrong data, how do we interpret it differently. And I think at the end of it, it created a lot of discussion as to how we can move forward. We heard some fantastic stories about how people have managed to change the culture in a trust and make trust, with a smaller T, more important. And I think if you've got good leadership and trust in that leadership, you can do so much better with a unit such as a hospital.
There were three key outputs from today's deliberations. Number one, that we voted on the key quality indicators to prioritize them. And there was a general agreement what is essential, what is desirable, and what is important. So I hope that people will take it away for further use in practice for the future. Number two, there was a general agreement that we should have a common language and a simpler classification system, which would allow proper communication with all concerned, which is understandable and meaningful. And number three, that there was general agreement that a consultant-led approach integrated with other experts like IT, finance director and managers would be a way forward in collecting accurate data which are reliable and usable in a practical sense in the future.